This is the preview of the lecture video on the topic fetal ascites, available on the ultrasound educational website www.sonoshare.in. This is only a preview. The complete video is available on the website. This will cover the features of ascites and whether it is part of eye drops or isolated, whether it's transudate or exudate, and various causes of transudative ascites and exudative ascites. Short parts of the various aspects of the video will follow. Having gone through the preview, if you wish to listen to the main lecture video, go to sonoshare.in. Fetal ascites. Fetal ascites is a lead point feature in the fetus. Once you see fetal ascites, diagnosis of eye drops, and it can be, there can be also as associated placentomegaly and polyhydramnios. So these are the features of eye drops fetalis. Here you see minimal fetal ascites. There is minimal pericardial fluid. There is a big list of non-immune eye drops. Now here you see a fetus with showing it's an Rh negative fetus. There is ascites. There is pericardial fluid. So two compartments. So there is eye drops. And there is also placentomegaly, and the MCA Doppler shows that there is anemia. So these are features seen in an Rh negative mother. So it is a immune. Also MCA Doppler shows anemia, but it is Rh positive, so it is not immune eye drops. It is a non-immune eye drops due to fetal anemia due to parvo infection. This is one example of non-immune eye drops. Here again, another in the placenta. So it is a choroangioma of the placenta. Present, it can result in either anemia or hyperdynamic circulation cardiac failure and result in non-immune eye drops. And this fetus has got ascites, exudate, as seen here, where the ascitic fluid is clear, or it can be an exudate, where you see ascitic fluid containing lot of internal echoes. So that is an exudate. High airway obstruction, and which also reveals a dilated trachea, fluid-filled trachea and bronchi. So dilated bronchi, typical appearance of congenital high airway obstructive syndrome. So chaos, urinary bladder outflow obstruction, and there is a breach in the wall of the urinary bladder, which has resulted in urinary ascites. So urinary ascites is a cause of transudative ascites as an isolated cause with an irregular contour. And in the hilum, you see dilated portal and splenic veins, both in grayscale as well as color. And the flow is away from the liver, hepato, the ascitic fluid, which are pointers for an exudative ascites. So when the ascites is isolated and it is an exudate, then the first thing we must suspect is a meconium peritonitis. So here two examples of meconium peritonitis, two fetuses. You see an isolated ascites, which is an exudate. And in this fetus, there is debris. You see fluid level solution without any sequela, either intrauterine or postnatally. Spontaneous resolution with sequela, like a small bowel obstruction, or there may be a residual meconium cyst or residual peritoneal calcifications. Now see an example of isolated fetal ascites due to meconium peritonitis at 32 in contour. There is debris inside, and within the debris you see bright echoes suggestive of calcifications. And you see adjacent to it dilated ileum, indicating ileal atresia. And in real time, the calcifications are highly echogenic, punctate, curvilinear or clumped foci in the peritoneal cavity with or without shadowing, and they are seen in the periphery of the abdomen along the where all peritoneum is there, that is in the periphery on the undersurface of the diaphragm or between the bowels. So here this is a resolved case of meconium peritonitis, and you see peritoneal calcifications along civilized anus. So these are all features of URSM sequence, urorectal septal malformation sequence, where there is a common opening, urinary tract, genital tract and the gut open into a common chamber. So that is with a one perineal opening, there is no anal opening. So urorectal septal malformation sequence, and which can present as exudative ascites. Another case, urinary bladder outflow obstruction. And when you see an endovaginal scan because of breech presentation, you see the ascites, exudative ascites, over distended bladder, and then posterior to the bladder you see the tubular cystic mass with 10 ascites. So it is not accommodating any more fluid, so the hydrocolpus becomes bigger. And there is also secondary obstruction to the urethra resulting in urinary bladder outflow obstruction. So there is ascites to start with, hydrocolpus then, and urinary bladder outflow obstruction due to distal vaginal atresia. So and because of the urine is not escaping out, so there is anhidramnios also. Fruit and a branch appearance. There is a single vessel from the iliac vessel supplying the mass. This is a female fetus, so this is an ovarian cyst which is complicated. Because of the complication, it has leaked into the peritoneal cavity, resulting in exudative ascites. So that is the exudative ascites, intraperitoneal mass, female, so it is an ovarian cyst and it is complicated. So complicated ovarian cyst presenting as exudative urinary ascites and hepatic fibrosis. Exudative ascites happens, main causes meconium peritonitis and URSM sequence and a complicated ovarian cyst. Thank you.